if you consider that you start filming a mouse's face and you start being able to read what the mouse seems to be thinking, what does it imply about what cameras could be trained to do with videos of our faces?
This is quite powerful because it suggests that videos are not just records of behavior, but they really represent a window into brain activity, basically.
In terms of what is private and what is public, it seems to be a bit more nuanced than we thought.
What we thought as originally our most private thoughts could now become an open book.
We wanted to understand the extent to which we could infer what the mice were thinking by looking at their facial musculature. Is the face an informative channel of our thoughts?
There had been some studies that suggested that there's emotional expressions in the face of a mouse. Different sorts of things that happen to the mouse get expressed, like we express sadness and happiness and anger and all of that. What about things that are not necessarily emotions? What about more complex things that might be reflective of even, say, cognitive strategies that the mouse was using?
We had discovered previously that neural activity in certain parts of the mice's brain represented the different strategies simultaneously all the time, regardless of the particular strategy that was being used by the mouse. And so this provided us with an opportunity to see whether the same would take place at the level of the face.
To study this question, we created a kind of strategic game for mice where they constantly had to make a decision, should I stay or should I go? The mouse is at a spot in a virtual environment and he had to lick at a spot to receive a sugary reward. And the trick is that the reward is unpredictable and at any given time the spot could run dry. So the mouse had to decide when is a good time to give up and explore the environment for another reward somewhere else by running on a little treadmill. And what is interesting in this task is that actually mice could play the game in a different way. They could adopt different strategies, and these strategies could be defined mathematically, and through computational models, we could predict which strategy the mouse was using and when. So by combining this experiment with other methods like videography and neural recording, we could directly test our questions.
And of course there, then the key challenge was actually to be able to extract facial movements. And this is something that we did by using machine learning algorithms that were already implemented in open source software that really allows us to extract on a frame-by-frame basis these tiny, sometimes facial movements.
And when we did that, we found, even to our surprise, that you could extract as much information about what the mouse was thinking, so to speak, from the face as you could from populations of neurons of the order of 100 or a couple of 100 of neurons.
Mice actually have a terrible poker face. We could read from their faces all their hidden strategies. And I think what was also truly surprising to me was that the facial expression linked to different strategies were actually the same for every mice.
This was not just something that was present on a single animal or a single session, but it was something that kind of generalized across sessions and across animals.
And we also identify a region in the brain, in the front of the brain, called the secondary motor cortex, that seems to be key to generate these strategies and this facial expression.
Indeed, the face is a kind of high throughput information channel about the contents of thought.
We also suggest that there's some hardwire mechanism in the brain to really broadcast this internal computation directly into the face of the animals.
Such technology could be an incredible tool to understand the neural and cognitive processes in mental health disorder, for instance. But it also raises the stakes for our mental privacy.
Default recording of people's behavior might actually be informative for things that those individuals might not necessarily want to share.
Think of the implication of such a technology used on all our videos that we post on social media.
We need more studies to understand how far that goes, and we need potentially to start a discussion about what's needed in regulation to make sure that this isn't abused.